మేము అప్లోడ్ చేసే ఈ వీడియోస్ మీ మొబైల్కి నోటిఫికేషన్స్లా రావాలంటే సబ్స్క్రైబ్ చేయండి, అలానే బెల్ ఐకాన్ క్లిక్ చేయండి. ఇఫ్ యూ వాంట్ టు రిసీవ్ మై వీడియోస్ టు యువర్ మొబైల్ యాజ్ నోటిఫికేషన్స్ డైరెక్ట్లీ, ప్లీజ్ సబ్స్క్రైబ్ అండ్ క్లిక్ ఆన్ బెల్ ఐకాన్. ప్లీజ్ వాచ్ అండ్ షేర్ టు యువర్ ఫ్రెండ్స్ టు మోటివేట్ అస్. మీ ఫ్రెండ్స్కి షేర్ చేయండి మా వీడియోస్.
Hi, this part of tutorial concentrates on the steps to customize the colormag WordPress theme. I hope you all are aware about the WordPress themes. These are the responsible elements to show your website in a structured way. Just log in with your WordPress admin console and go to the appearance from the left hand side navigation. And check the menu entries over there. These menu entries are responsible to show the headings or subheadings in your website. You might have seen the sections like technology, business, sports, all those, right? So based on the menu you create here, they will organize and appear in the website accordingly. So here you can create any new menu. And then from the left hand side you can select those pages and you can add to the menu structure. Whenever you add, they will come from left hand side to right hand side. Accordingly, they will appear in the website. You have to perform all these tasks from the WordPress admin console by logging into your WordPress website with the URL containing wp-admin at the end of your website. Here I selected someone, clicked on add to menu. Here you can see terms and conditions, contact us page, all these things. And then if you want to add posts also into your menu structure, you can add. If you want to add any kind of custom links, still you can add, which will appear in the main menu entry. If you want to delete any sections which you don't want, you can select the particular section, click on delete. Here download and theme information, I am removing it by clicking on the remove hyperlink. Just click on the arrow link on that particular menu subdirectory and then click on remove. You can see technology, fashion, health, layout. Try to observe each and every menu entry and do the modifications as per your requirement, you know. While organizing these menu items, first decide what are all the menu items you need actually. If you want to organize some of these menu items as a sub menu under any primary menu item, just you can remove and assign it to the existing theme. Here I am removing from the existing menu. After doing all the changes, click save menu, which will create the menu with the custom name which you used. You can see the download theme info which was there earlier. Now I am refreshing the website freshersl.com. Now you can see sports is the beginning one. Earlier we used to have download some team info, which I removed already. I added terms and conditions, contractors, those things newly, so now they are appearing. So after installing the color mag theme, now I am doing these post installation changes to customize the theme. Initially I performed this menu items creation and menu creation. Now I am clicking on appearance customize to go into the customize screen of the theme. This is the place where if you want to change to any other theme also, you can change here. Click on side identity where you can see the existing logos like color mag. You can upload your logos here. If your website has specific logos, you can upload here. I am uploading a logo for the website. If you have the logo image on your desktop, just try to upload. If you want to give title to that, you can give the title, description, everything for that particular image. And then click on save. With this change you will be able to see the odd pillar logo instead of the color mag logo in your website. Now it is appearing as blank instead of color mag. Now you can see it took a while to reflect it. So this is how you should change the logo of your website. If you want to update a tagline for your logo or site, you can update the site title and then tagline. Here you have the options to show only logo only or only site title, or if you want to show both, you can show both. There you can see site title color as color mag, you can change that as well. Tagline appears just below the site title. Here you can update. Here I updated Venelu and the Venna Telugu word pillar. So you can always customize with the kind of logo and then site title and then a tagline. And you can customize the options to show any one or both. You can edit the color mag advertisement there. That is the place where you can show ads in future if you get the monetization kind of stuff. You can change with any image if you want. Or you can remove it. Right now I am selecting an image temporarily. just to show how it works. Yes, I am uploading the logo again. Same image. After doing that, you can click on publish to reflect the changes in your actual website. Whenever you publish, then only it will reflect the changes permanently on your website. You can see the logo which is occupying a very big portion. You can always try to upload a relevant size of the image. Right now I am keeping as it is. If you want to delete, then you can delete as well. You can check the existing widgets and you can customize if you want. Mostly widgets show the sidebars and all those things. In future, if you want to add extra widgets, you can add. You can change the colors also, background color of the overall website. Here you can see the borders and all those things changed. You can give any URL. You can give any URL of the website or video to display the header media. You can give the image as well. You can give the video if you want to play at the header section of the website. So always try to plan some good images. Again, use the URL as an image. Click on the header options. After clicking on the customize from the appearance themes, click on the header options. There you can see main header area display, how we want to organize the things. Here three layouts are possible. Which one you want, you can select based on that, it will reflect the structure. If you select the third one, a logo, site title, they will appear in the middle portion of the website or central portion of the website. If you select the second one, so always try to observe the changes by previewing here and then decide which layout suits best at the header portion. You can check header image position where it should display the header image, just above the or between the headers. So if you click on any option, those header image position will change. After previewing the changes, decide which position is best fit in the area of website. So here you can see video is coming on to top and then the site title and then if you select the second one, it shows normally as like earlier. If you want to display breaking news section, you can click on the checkbox such that you know all the latest breaking news will appear on the header section as well. Show date, show home icon, over all these things you should check the box. Sticky menu, if you have the kind of menu at the fixed positions, you should select it. If you want to have the search icon displayed, you should select. For random post also you should do that. Responsive menu style means based on the device you use, you should be responsive. If you select that, then only it will become responsive menu style. So now come to the design options section. Earlier we saw the header options. Now we will check the design options where it shows the front page settings. Mainly it is related to the positions of the page, etc. And then layout, if you want to have a kind of standard layout or If you want to change to the available other layouts, this you can select whichever you prefer. It's always better to have a default layout in my point of view, unless until if you select other layouts. After selecting the layout, you can choose publish. If you publish, then only those changes will get reflected automatically. Come back and check out the options available. Site layout, here you can see different layouts. Just select any one layout and refresh your website. Here you can see the borders crossed, the borders of the headers crossed on the below portion with this layout. So always to open the website and check the I tried the both the layouts and verified which one is better, and finally I kept the default layout only. Just for verification purpose I select both the layouts and observed what are the changes when I previewed those two layouts. So you can see all the posts there. After making the required changes, you can always click on publish to save the changes permanently. You can see the default layout, how it looks like. And you can observe the default layout for pages, for single posts, how it looks like. And if you want to change the skin colors for the posts, you can change them. If you scroll down, go to the post section where you can see the skin changes, like sports are appearing in different color, health is appearing in different color. So all these colors and skins get changes. So this is also important step here. When you do the changes, just publish it. Now, whenever you do some changes and verify it, you can quickly publish them. Otherwise, you may forget those changes. If you do a lot of changes and then finally publish, if any issue comes to the website, you may not be able to remember which change caused the trouble. So after doing one or two changes itself, you just simply can click on publish if you are satisfied with those changes. Is that if anything happens, simply you can troubleshoot it. You can use the option of the primary color option. Just you can select the relevant color over there and then click on publish it. You can select the background color, social options, everything. If you click on the colors, you can select the color. Earlier we already saw it. Click on select color and select the relevant background color which you want to see. And finally, you can try to observe the social options as well. If you integrate those social options, it will be easier for you to publish to the relevant links. Click on the social links. There you can give the Facebook, Twitter, Google Plus, Instagram. If you give those links, whenever you post, whenever you write a new post, it will be easy for you to trigger the changes to do these particular social links. Even the website visitors also can follow your social websites by checking these things. Now, if you purchase a kind of premium version of this particular colormag theme, you can get extra benefits. You can go through the documentation and you can try them. Typography, like, you know, if you want to get some translation of those website content, it is possible pretty much with the premium theme. Appearance customize. In this way, you should customize the color, any theme. Here we are customizing the color mag theme. Yes, I am using that particular theme for blogging purpose here. So we saw site identity, means changing the logos and all colors, header options, background image, menus, widgets, home page settings and all we already reviewed here. So in future, if you want to customize anything, you should navigate like this: appearance, themes, customize, and check what are the options available here to customize them. Then try to customize them. I hope it is pretty much easy if you own a WordPress website to organize these contents. You can check the footer options, what it should display in the footer. Check if there are any additional options for customizing. If you want to show a kind of featured image also as part of the post, you can check the box. Category color settings. If you want to show different colors to different categories, you can set the colors. So, if you install any theme, first try to read the documentation for the customization options. If you want to follow best practices, that is the way only you can customize the things. When you read the documentation, you can collect the information of the support info also, so that you can contact the support team if you encounter any issues. I hope you like my video. If you want to translate the colormag application, you can click on the translate icon. Actually, this comes with the pro version. And here you can check the available languages to translate automatically. Here I don't see the Telugu version actually. Yeah, now I can see the Telugu. So if you have premium theme, you can try that. This overall feature comes with the pro version actually. If you buy a premium page, you can try this website to get translated into Telugu language as well. Just click on that. And it's telling it is not translated up to the desirable portion. If you want to contribute, you can contribute. So this is how you can customize any theme in future. If you like this video, please like it and share the video to your friends. Subscribe and click bell icon to follow all my tutorials. Thank you very much for watching this video.
మేము అప్లోడ్ చేసే ఈ వీడియోస్ మీ మొబైల్కి నోటిఫికేషన్స్లా రావాలంటే సబ్స్క్రైబ్ చేయండి, అలానే బెల్ ఐకాన్ క్లిక్ చేయండి. ఇఫ్ యూ వాంట్ టు రిసీవ్ మై వీడియోస్ టు యువర్ మొబైల్ యాజ్ నోటిఫికేషన్స్ డైరెక్ట్లీ, ప్లీజ్ సబ్స్క్రైబ్ అండ్ క్లిక్ ఆన్ బెల్ ఐకాన్. ప్లీజ్ వాచ్ అండ్ షేర్ టు యువర్ ఫ్రెండ్స్ టు మోటివేట్ అస్. మీ ఫ్రెండ్స్కి షేర్ చేయండి మా వీడియోస్.